Hi guys, so we are going to look into this question that if I would like to settle abroad, is it possible for me, or what to do in order that settling abroad becomes easier for me. Okay, so in this video we are going to look into that. We are going to do a pick a card reading with the cards that I have been using over and over, and by now if you have been watching my videos often, you might already know that these are the decks that are exclusively available only with my Angel Card Divination course. And this is the Angel Guidance Oracle cards and this is the Angel Solutions Oracle cards, and both of these decks are created by me and they are available only with my Angel Card Divination course. And the thing is that these cards are something that I was expecting from an angel card deck, and yeah, I have got a couple of angel card decks, and usually one card deck is actually for, one is meant for romance, one is meant for life purpose, one is meant for something else. So there was no common deck which I felt that a common deck was needed. Like half for tarot, we have a common tarot deck, right? But for angel cards, there was no common deck, and that is where I just thought that it was needed. It's not available in the market, so don't ask me, ma'am, where to buy these cards. They are just available with my course. And yeah, so in this video, we are going to see whether you can settle abroad or not, and what to do if you would want to settle abroad. Also, I would like to clarify this, that a lot of people, you know, who watch the video, they are somewhere, you know, they don't want to settle abroad, and then they are watching the video and then they say, oh ma'am, I did not get my answer. See, if this is your burning question, whether I would be able to settle abroad or not, or what to do in order to settle abroad, then do definitely watch this video. It is for you. Okay, so make sure that you watch this entire video. I am not giving any timestamps because I sometimes give certain instructions in between here and there, and that is why I don't give timestamps. But that is why I create very, very, very in short videos. You don't have to go through an entire 1 hour long video. And yeah, so stay tuned. Okay guys, so let's begin with the reading. And I have just completed shuffling the deck, and I have already got all the three options ready for you. This is the option 1, 2 and 3. Now what I want is that you close your eyes and focus on your question. Will I be able to settle abroad? And if at all something needed to be done, what it is that I can do so that I can settle abroad? Okay, so just try to focus on your question in your mind, and now you can open your eyes. No, I just assume that you have already thought of, it's not a logical thinking, but your angels, your guides and the divine will guide you towards one intuitive option, and just try to go ahead with that option. And yeah, now we are going ahead with the options in sequence. So this is the number one option. If you have chosen number one, then the thing is, it says that, okay, settling abroad. The first thing I would like to say here is that, you know, first of all, yeah, you are actually thinking of settling abroad, and you will need guidance. You will need guidance from somebody who is dealing with immigration and all that stuff. Plus, you need to do something. You need to settle abroad through the way of studying, right? Through studying something, and then based on that studies, you are going ahead and carrying forward your education, right? So that is the first thing that is coming from here. Also, the second thing I would like to say is that, yeah, see, usually the graduation studies or the schooling studies is something what people do, and then they carry forward the studies once they go abroad. But here the cards are also telling me not just the academic studies, also try to study something like yoga or healing, you know, because that will also help you to make a side income. Okay, so that way that's going to be a very good source of side income to you in future once you shift there. Okay, so that is the first option. That is the number one option that is showing up for you. Also, just try to very closely follow what your guide is telling you. You know, your immigration or something that people do for students. You know, they call the IELTS exams, the TOEFL exams and all those sort of exams. There are going to be people who help you with those exams. There are going to be people who help you to figure out which country is going to be better for you based on your points, right? So just try to be very close to this. Yeah, just try to have a very close consultation with these people and follow them closely, okay? Because what your tutor, what your mentor is going to tell you, it's going to help you to a large extent. That is the only thing that's going to help you, right? So yeah, that is for the first option. Now let's get into the second option. So if you are somebody who is, if you are somebody who has chosen option number two, you know, for the option number two people, I would like to say that this can be a journey for you. And you know, a lot of you guys can be where you are trying to settle abroad, you are trying to try hard a lot, you are trying to make efforts towards settling abroad, you are trying that hard, but maybe your efforts are not going to be that effective. Okay, I'm just to be honest, I'm telling you that means you can actually work abroad, but it's not for settling abroad for you is not going to be the best option. Okay, so that's not the right thing that I can say. Settling abroad would not be the right thing. Plus, I would like to say that just try to go abroad, just try to earn good money and then come back. Okay, so that is like, you know, you can just go abroad, earn for 5 to 10 years, earn a good amount of money, save a good amount of money and then come back here. Okay, come back wherever you are. Okay, I'm not saying here, just come back wherever you are. So because this is like a reading that is valid for people all over the world. So yeah, so that is where I'm saying that. Yeah, so this is for the option number two. Now let's get into the option number three. Okay. So for the people who have option number three, okay, so now, you know, for option number three people, it is showing that going to abroad, settling abroad, it can be like a very, very bad option for you. It can be actually not exactly bad, but a very difficult option for you because there can be a lot of things, there can be a lot of problems that are underlying. That is first thing. The second thing is, maybe education wise you cannot go, maybe you have just gone ahead of the age limit that is where you can just migrate and all that stuff, so maybe that is also happening. The third thing I would like to say is that you are having quite a good time here itself, in your country itself, and that is where going to some other country, it might be a totally imbalancing option. Means you're just trying to disturb, you're just trying to imbalance your entire life here and then you're trying to go and settle there, and that is where it might not be the best option for you. Okay, so here I would like to say that see whatever I am telling you, whatever I am actually trying to tell you is actually what the cards are saying, right? It's based on the angel cards, but you may want to have professional advice on this. So just try to get some professional advice from some immigrant, office or from some advisor or something, because there you will be able to get better advice on what exactly can be done. And yeah, there are very faint chances, like 20% of chances for you to go abroad, and this can include, this can mean that you can go for a vacation abroad like every few years. That can be done easily for you, but here, just going and settling abroad forever, I don't see that coming very easily. I don't see that happening very easily, right? Because there are a number of problems that are lying in your thing, that are lying in your, in your life, and that is where you just cannot move abroad easily. Right, so even going there on a work visa, it can be a very tough thing, it can be a very difficult thing. So just going out for a holiday, for a vacation, that would be good, right? So yeah, so this is the option number three, and I hope that you like this reading. If you have liked this video, hit the like button. If you feel that this video will help somebody, do share this video with that person. I will see you again in my next video. For the second video, I would like to say that the work option was good. Working for 5 to 10 years is good. And if you try to apply for work visa, because this is like a global reading, plus a lot of people will be watching this video. I'm not saying the exact time. So time limit can be once you apply for that work visa, within 6 months to 1.5 to 2 years, that process might actually complete and you might actually go step further. So yeah, so that can be there. And plus the thing with studies. Studies thing, it again depends on you, because if you are a student, you may take some time finishing your studies. If somebody of you is totally educated, who are totally complete with their studies, you just have the final thing left, that you just put your file and you wait for the thing to happen, right? So if it is that case, it might be 1 to 1.5 years. And if you are a student, you need to first complete your education, and then onwards you will be going ahead with your going abroad thing, right? So yeah, so this is the thing for the going abroad thing. I hope that you like it. If you have liked this video, hit the like button. If you feel that this video can help somebody, do share this video with that person. I will see you again in my next video. Do let me know in the comment box below which is the next pick a card reading you would like me to do. Okay, so thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for being with me. Keep following the path of your soul's purpose, because you are born for a reason. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.